you serious?
Yeah, this is my serious face.
Oh my God, no. No, this is crazy.
What? Great, even better.
Get married here, now.
Yes, why not? It's New York. It's Christmas time. The whole city is blanketed in snow. It's lit up. It looks like it's lit up for us. What could be more romantic than that?
Not much.
Then let's do this. Let's start the new year as husband and wife. Come on. So you'll marry me tonight.
Look, we've had an emotional day seeing the 9/11 memorial and the names of people that you know. It's obviously stirring up a lot of things, like thoughts about mortality and how we have to grab life and live it while we can.
Right. We just agreed on that.
Right. Yeah. The point that I'm trying to make is getting married tonight might seem like a great idea now, not so much tomorrow.
No, I can't wait to wake up in the morning and look over at you as my new wife. I mean, I have no doubt about that in my head or in my heart. It sounds like you might have some doubts, so
no,
if you do, now's a good time to talk.
I don't. Not about marrying you. I'm just wondering why it has to be tonight. Why can't it be New Year's Eve or, like, Valentine's Day?
Because we're here now, committed to each other in the most amazing city in the world at Christmas time. What is better than that?
I don't want to disappoint you.
Well, then don't.
I'm not trying to back out.
Are you sure about
that? Yes.
Well, then what?
I'm just thinking about our families. Like, Olivia, seriously, think about her. She would die if she didn't see her baby boy giving his wedding vows. I mean, your wedding day is a big deal, and it's going to be one of the happiest days of your life. Do you really think she would be okay with missing that?
She would probably never talk to me ever again, which might not be a bad thing.
But she would be really hurt.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, you have a point. I will call my mother. I will tell her we'll do it tomorrow. That gives her plenty of time.
What are we going to do tomorrow? Where are we going to have the ceremony? City Hall is closed
for
the holidays.
There's hundreds of churches out there.
Churches are doing Christmas ceremonies.
I'm sure someone can fit us in.
What are the chances?
There's only one way to find out. Are you up for this or not?
I'm in.
That is a good answer.
I told you it was hopeless.
No, nothing is hopeless. We just need to regroup on plan B. Why don't you call Maxie?
Maxie?
Yeah, she's your best friend. She's got connections in New York. Maybe she can hook
us up. First of all, it's Christmas Eve. Even if I was willing to ask her to basically work the phone, she wouldn't get a hold of anyone. And secondly, if I mention the word wedding to her, it's already past the point of no return, and she's going to make it crazier than we can handle.
All right. I get it. Maxie's out.
And what about Olivia? She goes to church a lot, so maybe she has an in with a priest or something.
Yeah. Wait a second. What I do? My cousin Tommy, he was this total badass as a kid, and he became a priest. He could fit us in between services, maybe.
We can't just follow this guy on Christmas Eve and ask him to accommodate
us. Sure we
us.
Can. That's what families are for. I'm going to call him right now. All set.
You're kidding.
No, he said he would perform the ceremony.
Wow. I guess miracles really do happen.
Hey, I'm sensing a total lack of enthusiasm on your part.
No.
I mean, speak now or forever hold your peace.
It's just, I don't know, I just got sad a little.
Sad?
Wedding.
Sad about us getting married? Maybe I am doing something wrong.
No, it's not you. It's just that it's not exactly how I imagined it would be.
All right, I'm an idiot. You mentioned my mother because you thought I'd like to have her there, and you didn't even think to include your family. Is that why you're being hesitant? You want your family there?
Did that cross my mind?
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, no, forget it. We'll wait till we get back. I'll call Tommy.
No,
right now.
Honestly, what's the point? My family isn't even really available. I'm not even on good terms with my dad, and even if I was on good terms with him, he's cynical and he doesn't believe in the institution of marriage.
Well, he's lucky.
Yeah, he's been a mess since Siobhan died, and Nicholas is in Greece, and Ethan's running around Windermere.
What about Carly? I mean, she's your cousin.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't want anyone who doesn't wish us well at our wedding.
You don't think she would wish us well?
No, she would pretend to, and I don't want to celebrate our wedding that way.
So it's just us?
Till death do us part.
Are you sure you're good? We're really gonna do this?
Yes, unless you change your mind at the last minute.
No, not a chance.
Then we're doing this.
Even with the lack of family, you're okay? You sure?
Yeah. You're my family now, and Olivia, and that's all I need.
You know, you're gonna have falconeries coming out of the woodwork to welcome you into the clan. You're gonna have more aunts and uncles and cousins than you'll know what to do with.
I can't wait.
I'm gonna have my best life ever.
I can't wait to start. Oh, wait. Oh, my God. My clothes. I don't have anything to wear tomorrow. It's a wedding day.
You know what? It's
I don't
okay.
have a dress
okay.
or anything.
We'll make a run in the morning. Right now, clothes are optional.